Hey folks, do you know how to make your Android phone awesome? Obviously you do, by customization or if you are an advanced user by rooting your phone and flashing custom ROM using Xposed Framework, etc. If you ask me what's that one thing that I can do to make my Android phone more awesome, it would be hard for me to come up with one definitive answer, but I can tell you from where you can start. In order to root your phone or flash a custom ROM, you need to have a custom recovery installed on your device, as the stock recovery that comes with your Android device is very limited in terms of features. For instance, you cannot root or flash a custom ROM using stock recovery, and this is where third-party recovery or custom recovery like TWRP comes handy. Apart from performing basic tasks, it lets you carry out advanced tasks like rooting, taking full backups, flashing ROMs, and a whole lot more. And that's exactly why today I'll be showing you a step-by-step guide to install TWRP recovery on Android devices which is supported officially or unofficially. Excited? So let's get started. Now before we move forward, the prerequisites are, first, your bootloader should be unlocked. Second, your battery should be at least 60% charged. Since not all Android devices are same, TWRP is built differently for each. Also, you might find the recovery available as both official and unofficial build on the internet. This is because TWRP recovery is an open source project and anyone with the knowledge can compile a TWRP recovery build for any Android device. So in short, TWRP recovery is supported by most of the Android devices. Now first, let's see how you can find TWRP recovery file for your specific device. For the demonstration purpose, I'm using a OnePlus 5. So I will simply go to the official website of TWRP recovery, then devices. Here I will type the name of my device, that is OnePlus 5, and here is the official TWRP recovery for my device. So that's how you can download the official TWRP recovery file for your specific devices. Now there are times when you are not able to find TWRP recovery on the official website, which usually happens with the latest devices. And in that cases, people usually think, or I should say conclude, that the video is just a clickbait and they start showing their love in the comment section. You know what I mean, right? But the main reason behind why they are not able to find their devices in the official website is either their devices are too old or the devices is from a local manufacturer. But don't worry, there is still a hope for those who are not able to find their devices in the official TWRP website. As I mentioned earlier, TWRP recovery is an open source project and anyone with the knowledge can compile a TWRP recovery build for any Android device. And that's exactly what the good folks at XDA Forums do. You can simply head over to XDA Forum and type your device name or you can also Google it. Here you will definitely find an unofficial build for your device which also works fine as an official build. So just download it. Now the next file that you will be needing is the SDK platform tool for which I'll be leaving the download link in the description down below. From here, download the SDK platform tool according to your OS as it supports Windows, Mac and Linux also. I'll be downloading the Windows version which is around 4 MB. Once downloaded, extract the file. Now head over to the TWRP recovery image file that we downloaded earlier and move the file to this folder. Once done, head over to your Android device and now we have to enable USB debugging. For that, open setting menu on your device. Now go to about phone and tap 7 times on build number. This will enable developers option. Now go back to setting and you will see a developer option there. Open it and scroll down until you see USB debugging option and just enable it. Now you're good to go. Now let's move towards the main process of installing the TWRP recovery. Step 1. Open a command window or PowerShell inside that folder. To do that, hold shift and press right click on the mouse on any empty white space inside the folder and then select open command window here from the context menu. Step 2. Boot your device into fastboot mode and this basically include a combination of power and volume button. If you don't know your device combination, then just Google it. Step 3. Connect your device to PC via USB cable and make sure your device is almost 60% charged. Step 4. To check whether your device is properly connected or not, type fastboot devices and it will enlist your device. If it's not showing your device like this, then make sure your USB cable is connected properly or reinstall your drivers. Step 5. Now once your device is listed, type fastboot space flash space recovery space TWRP and press tab. This will automatically fill the TWRP file name and press enter. That's all. TWRP recovery should be installed on your device now. Now you can go ahead and do whatever you want. Flash custom ROMs, take backup, or root your device if not yet rooted. Whenever you are about to use TWRP, take a backup of your files first. Performing tasks like flashing new ROMs or rooting might break your phone, so it's always a good idea to take backups. TWRP allows you to do it, and it's easy too. There you have it guys, a bit longer rather an easy guide on how to install TWRP recovery on any Android device. Were you able to successfully install TWRP or you stuck somewhere between? Don't worry, let me know in the comment section, I can always help you out. And for more future videos like this, do consider subscribing and hit the bell icon so that you never miss any future video from Xposed Framework. So this is Samir signing off, and I'll see you guys in my next one.